We've been talking about percentages, so now we're going to look at our percentages in a little bit of a different way. We're going to talk about percent increase or marking up things with money, and percent decrease or discounts when we talk about money. So we're still using our percentages out of 100, so keep that in mind. This particular example is about vets. Vets care for the health of animals. They do this at home, zoos, labs. Some work in clinics, some go to farms. So in 2010, the U.S. said that we had 61,400 vets, and the government is predicting that we will need more vets in 2013. In fact, they're predicting we needed 2,200 more. So if we take that 61,400 plus the 2,200, so this is what we had in 2010, then in 2013, they're saying we will have 83,400 veterinarians. So if we're going to find out how much that increased as a percentage, not as an actual number, but as a percentage, we need to look at the difference from 2010 to 2013. Well, that would normally be a subtraction, but because they gave us 200 more, that is our actual difference. Now, the original number, that's going to be what we had in 2010. They want us to then apply this percent increase decrease equation to find out how much it went up as a percentage, not as an actual number. So in order to do this, we're going to write our difference, our 22,000 over 61,400. We're going to need to change that to a decimal, and then we can multiply it by 100 because that will change it to a percent, because remember, percents mean out of 100. Now, in order for us to divide this nicely, I'm going to take these zeros off so it's not quite so ugly. And I'm going to do this, I'll do it over here in the margin, and I'm going to say 614 into 220. Here's my decimal. Remember, this is going to come out to a decimal, and that's okay. So 614 doesn't go into 2 or 22 or 220, but it does go into 2,200. So we can say, well, 6 times 4 is 24. That's a little too much. So let's try 3. 3 times 4 is 12. 3 times 1 plus 1 is 4. 3 times 6 is 18. And then we're going to have to do a little bit of borrowing. So this becomes an 11. That becomes 0. So 10 minus 2 is 8. 9 minus 4 is 5. 11 minus 8 is 3. Don't forget to bring down the 0. And we can say, well, 6 goes into 35. Not quite 6 times, so I'm going to try 5. 20, carry the 2. 5 times 1 plus 2 is 7. And this is 30. 0, 1, 5. We're going to go just one more just to see if we need to round up or down. And 6 goes into 51. Well, say 7 is only 42. 6 times 8 is 48. That's closer. 6 times 9 is 54. So that's going to be too much. So we're going to go with an 8. And we're going to stop after 3 places behind the decimal. So it doesn't really matter what that comes out to be when we subtract it. So I'm going to bring this 0.385 down over here, back to my original. So this 358, I misspoke, times 100. Well, we know when we do times 100, it's really just going to move our decimal this way. So we are saying that the percent increase in veterinarians will be 35.8%. That's the percentage it will go up. We can do the same thing with decrease. If there will be 10,000 fewer veterinarians in 2013, what is that decrease? Guys, this is always the same formula, the difference. Well, it's telling us the difference is 10,000 because it's fewer. So 10,000 over our original was still that 61,400, So we're going to have to do some division. Again, I'm going to come over here to the margin. These little boxes are really handy at keeping us nice and organized. Well, not 1, not 10, not 100, into 1,000 is 1. I misaligned that, I apologize, 614. 10, 9, 9, 0, 3, 8, 6, 0. 6 goes into 38, we'll call it 6 times. 24, 8, 36, 15, that's a 7. So 1, 76, and again, only go out 3 places, otherwise it just gets to be too much. So times 3 is 18, that's too much. So we're going to go with 2, and we're going to stop. So when I come back over here, I know this is 0.162, I'm going to times it by 100 to make it a percent. So 16.2%, and this is decrease. That means that it's going to go down that much. This was an increase. A pet album, so we can see this with money as well. That was $12.50, was put out on sale for $8.50. What is the percent decrease? So again, the difference. Well, I need to subtract these to find out how much the price went down. $12.50 minus $8.50. Most of you can do that in your head. $4. So it went down $4 over the original. Which of these was the original? Well, it usually sells for $12.50. So we're going to have to do some more division here. So we're going to come over. Now, we cannot have a decimal outside. So 12. I'm not going to worry about that 0. Here's my 4. I got to move it once. Here's my 0. 125 goes into 400. Well, that's 2 is 250. So 4 is going to be 500. That's too much. So let's go with 3. 15, carry the 1. That's a 7. 375. I know 400 minus 375 is 25. We already said that's 2. So I can put this. Is 0.32 times 100. I know that this price went down 32%. So again, you're just using that same method over and over. The price of a set of feeding bowls for dogs had been $9.25. That's our original, but it was increased. Also went up. So we're still going to have to subtract these, put the bigger one on top. Carl, that's a 0, 10, 10, 1.85 is the difference. Now the original is 925. I'm going to go ahead and move my 2 places. So I have 925 into 185. I already moved my decimal, so that's a nice thing. Nope. 9 times 2 is 18, and 25 times 2 is 50. So there we go. So 0.2 times 100 is a 20% increase. Now, when we talk about do not do this back piece, we're going to go over here to this 12.2. So when we talk about markup and discounts, it's the same thing. When we go to pay for things, a markup means that we're going to have to pay more than the people who are selling it had to buy it for. And a markdown is a decrease. So if you look, since a pet owner bought a leash at the office, leash cost the vet $225. From the supplier, but they're going to mark it up 45%. Because remember, when you go to a store and you buy something, they're going to mark it up more than what they paid so they can make some money. So if we look at this, what was the price that we paid? This is our percent proportion. This is our 100%, and it's going to go up 45. So my part, I'm looking for that. Now, technically, based on what we've learned, if it goes up 45%, we are paying 145%. And the original, this 225, is 100% of what they paid. So we can cross multiply this. Now make sure when you do that, you keep everything nice and straight. Don't forget your placeholder. And 9, 2 placeholders on this one, 5, 2, 2. So 5, 2, 6, 12, 3. And then we're going to divide by 100, which means we're going to go, oh, I forgot to move my decimal first here. 1, 2 for that. And then when we divide that by 100, 326.25. Divided by 100, we know that's going to move two more places. So we are going to end up paying $3.26. You could find 45 and add it to the 225. Same thing now if they want to make a profit. So what is the percent markup? So this is your difference. And we're still using that original leash of 225. So you can see when we put that in there, it comes out to 1/3. So this is just another way of looking at markups without percent proportion. So those are our notes for tonight. Tomorrow in class, you're going to do an assignment. Have a great evening.